Okay, I'm back working on this 2008 GMC Acadia, and today we're going to be replacing the valve cover gaskets, and at the same time we're going to need to do the intake gaskets because we're going to be disturbing them to get to the valve cover gaskets. The last video I was putting some spark plugs on here and noticed there was oil down in the spark plug wells. So we're just now getting around to these valve cover gaskets. So I'm going to go ahead and show you what I've got here. Okay, so I've got these at AutoZone. Now you want to make sure, because some of these kits don't have the seals for the spark plug wells and stuff, so make sure that you get one that has these. And I know they sell them separate, and it'll be more expensive that way, but this kit has everything you need in it. And just to tell you, these are kind of pricey. I think it was like $53 just for the valve cover, and then it was about the same for the intake gasket. So these are kind of pricey. You probably could find them and order them maybe a little bit cheaper, but they're going to be, you know, looking at around $100 or more just to do this job here. Before we get started, we're going to disconnect the negative here. Come in here and pop this little piece up, and we've got a T20 right here. You're going to take your Torx and just take that screw out right there, and then this little panel will lift up here, no problem. Alright, so here is our 10 millimeter. Don't get carried away with tightening or loosening that, because you can break that piece right here. So we're just going to loosen that off, lift that up, make sure that it's securely out of the way where it's not going to touch. Okay, so we got that disconnected, and I just got it set down there out of the way where it's not going to hit. Alright, so first thing, we're going to remove this decorative piece here. Just pull it up. Okay, next thing up, we're going to loosen these two bands here and take this piece or this section out. Now this will lift right up and out of here, no problem. Just basically just start wiggling this loose, and I'm just going to stick that. Okay, we're going to have several things on this intake to remove. We're just going to get started with some of these connectors, and it's not a bad idea to label things. Now these will be zip tied here if they're not broken, and you'll need to unclip that or cut it loose or whatever. Now, this is not a really good method of holding these here, so I'm going to see about putting, I've got a kit that has a lot of these, we'll see about putting something back there a little bit better. Okay, this vacuum, give that a pull up. We'll disconnect that down at the back as well, but we'll get to that. If you can see these, you'll have a clip, or you should have a clip here and here on this wire harness. So go ahead and take care of that. Okay, I'm coming down under here to get this vacuum running to this purge valve. And we're going to, I think we're just going to disconnect it. Squeeze these green tabs here. We'll pop that out. And it may pull off this little bracket too. Okay, there's that. So you just got two green tabs you push on both sides. We got that loose. Let's tuck that out of the way. We've got this connector right here. I think we'll go ahead and disconnect it right here and just leave that attached. Okay, so there's that connector, so you just press down right there. This hose runs up to the throttle. Here we may have to wind up taking that off as well. We're gonna go ahead and get on this throttle body, get that disconnected. Okay, so I think we're gonna go ahead and take this loose because it's gonna get in the way. That's just our little purge valve. We're gonna slip that out of the way. Okay, I think we're gonna go ahead and get on this fuel line here. Now, just a word of caution, make sure that you have safety glasses. Even if you've bled the system, it's a good idea to pull the fuse and bleed the pressure off. And I did not do that. So what I'm gonna be doing is wrapping a rag around it as we're taking this loose. Let's see if we can find our disconnect tool here. This is just your average, ordinary disconnect tool. I believe it's like a 3/8 or something. But they do have plastic ones too for disconnecting AC and cooler lines, etc. So whatever you can get to fit on here, we'll just figure out what is going to be our appropriate size. Sometimes you have to put some lubricant on here. So I've got that locked in. I'm gonna got several rags. And you'll kind of give it a push in while you're pushing that set, and have your safety goggles ready to go. Okay, so it's gonna be a little bit stubborn here, looks like. You notice how I'm like pushing it up that way onto my tool. And if this one doesn't work, I've got other ones. I'm kind of rotating a little bit too. Sometimes you have to rotate it to get it to let loose. Okay, so you see about got it off of there already. We're just wiggling it off. I'm gonna make sure this is on here. Okay. And surprisingly, there's no pressure whatsoever, but there will be a lot of fuel leaking out of here, so you might as well go ahead and get a rag or something and start catching it now, because this is going to be leaking the whole time. And it goes without saying, you do not want to be working on this engine if it's hot. You want to make sure it's completely cooled off. Okay, so coming back here, we've got this vacuum hose. Just give that a pull off. It could have a little spring clamp on it. This one don't. Okay, if you can see back in here, follow this one. It goes down to the back there. We're going to be taking that loose. It has the same sort of little, you push the little connector over and it will release. So we're just gonna go ahead and get back there and disconnect that and get it out of the way. All right, so here's the little connector I was talking about. You just push it over and lift it up. Okay, I wanna focus on removing this insulation here. Probably got a couple of screw things like this that are broken, but it's kinda comes in halves, and we should, yeah, there's some more underneath there. They're just like this. Should be able to slip this off. Just got some little tabs. But it also has some like down under here. You can see I'm gonna get to those. Okay, so I've got the ones out of this front piece. Got that out of the way. I don't know, I can't really see this back one to see what's holding it. I'm gonna have to try to reach around there. Okay, so this piece has a couple of these directly in the back. You can feel for them there. And you should be able to lift this up and out of the way. All right, so now we can actually go about getting to our bolts and stuff here, but we've got another connector over here on this other side we need to get to. Okay, right down here we've got this connector. I'm just going to pop it off this bracket. You could take that 10 millimeter there loose as well, but I'm going to try to pop it out of here without breaking it. Okay, you got a gray safety lock right there. You got to push that back. Let's make sure it's pushed back. And push down. I don't think I've got it back far enough. All right, heard it click that time. Okay, so there we have that. And there's like a liner that's plugged off here, but you may have that hooked to something, so disconnect that on yours. And I think, okay, we've got the power steering reservoir, looks like up here. Okay, right under here we got a 10 millimeter that's going in to our intake there. We're gonna go ahead and take that out. Now we will be getting around to moving the rest of these wires, but for now, and these are really going to be tight, these little M6, M8 bolts should never be so tight. You have to use a big ratchet to get them loose. Okay, we're going to take the time to clean a lot of this off and blow it off with air and stuff before we go to removing this. Okay, so I've got my 13 here. We're gonna just start. This is just removing the upper. We'll have to, got to get the upper off of here, and then we can get the lower. Now, said if I'm going to be disturbing something, I want to make sure to do it right, regardless of whether I can get away with just replacing the uppers or not. You know, I don't want to do all this work, get it back together, and then you got to find out you got a vacuum leak somewhere. So it just makes sense to take the time to get both of your intakes. That way it's something you don't have to worry about down the road. I do not recall the exact miles on this. I'm gonna have to check. Okay, so we've got one hidden down here in the back. You see where my fingers are at. We got one down there as well. Now this insulation up under here is really itchy to get on your skin. I'm about to get a shorter one here, it looks like. Let's see if I can get to this one down here. Okay, so I believe there's just the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. For the upper, but we'll find out in just a second. Okay, so I had to switch over to just a short 13, because that one I couldn't get to. Okay, so I'm just gonna go ahead and finish removing these six. Now pay attention to where they come from. You don't want to get them mixed up. So if you need to mark them, whatever, see how long of a bolt that is, just make sure that you pay particular attention to where they come from so you're not getting confused going back together. It's just not a bad idea just to label everything. It takes a little bit longer, but then you don't have any time going back in trying to figure stuff out. So I'm going to go ahead and get the rest of these out. Okay, these shorter ones are kind of at the corner, so I know where they go. So the main thing is I want to try to get this lifted up without taking the big long bolts out. And I've probably still got some other things attached here. But we're going to see. Okay, I don't have that one all the way loose. Okay, completely remove the big long ones up here in the front. Okay, so I'm just lifting up the back ones. More than likely won't come out with it in place. I'm just gonna try to lift it up through here. May get my, should be able to get these out now. I believe these are all the same length, these long ones. So there won't be any confusion because those are all. So this is the final. Okay, so we've got it loose. It's just difficult to move with the bolts. Okay, so I'll mangle that up, taking it off of there. And you'll note that it's got the place for the alignment pegs. So when you put these back, there shouldn't be any issues. Just kind of looking at them. They don't just look horrible. But when you disturb something, you can just bet on it leaking when you put it back together. Okay, so I think the next thing we're going to get on is removing this. I'm trying to, okay, so we've got a connector over here that was on this one thing. So all we got to do, okay, so all we got to do is push down here, separate that. And so that makes it easy for us. And then we'll go ahead and get down here to these. I don't remember the size, and we'll find out in just a second. Okay, so I got a 13 here again. We got one over here in this corner. Okay, there's those two out of each corner. Just should be able to break it loose. I have seen them be stuck pretty severely. Okay, we got a wire over here. Pop that off. Okay, now this whole thing will lift up out of here. We'll just transfer our rags over. Okay, well, again, we want to make sure we get any loose debris before we go to popping these valve covers off. I'm just going to start on the roof. Okay, we got some wires clipped back here. Okay, we're gonna try to slip this back over here out of the way. We've got a few more connections. We got a O2 sensor, looks like, with the safety lock here. It's got to be pulled through like that. And you just lift up. Like most things, it wants to be difficult. Okay, so we got to also unclip that from this wire as well. I have to remember to put that back. Okay, see how that clips around that wire, just holds it up out of there from getting on the exhaust. Let's see, it may have another wire. We may be able to get enough slack to push it back. I was kind of wanting to wrap it over here out of the way. Let me take a look at it. Okay, as it turns out, I cannot remember what's holding this piece on over here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna come back up here and start taking everything off of this one, because this one's the same way, so I can figure out. I just can't remember how that was, this part where the wires running into are attached here. And then it doesn't help that we've got the Freon line here. So I'm gonna have to get back up here, and we're just gonna go ahead and take everything loose here and get the power steering pulled over out of the way where I can get a look at this one over here. Okay, coal packs are out. So just O2s, you just pop that safety lock. Okay, we do have another connector going down there. Just gonna try, I'm kind of playing this by ear, see what little I can remove. Trying to work around. I will say that I haven't found anything easy on these Acadias yet. Okay, so this is clipped in right here. Need to get that out. Get this power steering out of our way. Okay, so we got another one here. This has been my handiest tool lately. It came with a little trim kit. And I mean, I use it all the time. I think the whole kit with the fasteners and everything was like $20 or less. Okay, so we got all those wires unclipped there, and that actually gives me a lot more slack. We've got two 10 millimeters, you can't see like nuts on there. Okay, so there's the one on the back side, and then you come over here, there's one right there. So we're just gonna be taking both of those out. Again, these are really tight. You wanna use a magnet, keep from losing these. So we got the one back here. I'll tell you, when nuts and bolts fly off, you just never find them again. Okay, and there's that back one. Now we should be able to lift this. Okay, so I got the tank actually loose, but the bracket is still attached up here. And I want to say that it's not real easy to get to. Okay, next thing up, I'm going to take this overflow tank off of here. I'm going to have to figure out how to get down there to that bracket, and I think this is going to be the easiest place to start, maybe. Okay, I went ahead and popped this piece off. I need to replace this cap anyway. I thought about just taking this completely out of the way, but I'm just going to lay it here. But I was looking at this, and this bracket here is going underneath this coolant hose, And seems like the best I remember when last time I was replacing the engine, that bracket's not easy to get to by no means. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna switch gears. I'm gonna take this box out. It's not real difficult. We got a 13 or 14 there. And we got to, it's just some basic clips to get this up and off of here. You separate this from the lower part, and then we get this whole box out of the way. What I want to do is try to get to this mount down here. I think I'm going to support the engine, but I think I'm going to have to take that mount. I still may have to take this coolant hose out of the way. I'm not real sure because I can't really see anything at this point. And I'm trying to remember, but it seems, to the best of my knowledge, there was at least two more of these bolts that are difficult to get to that are down there on the front of that engine for this bracket. And there's going to be no way that we're going to get this this valve cover off of here with this bracket up here in the way like this. So anyways, I think I'm going to do that, and we're just going to clear up some more room here. You know, and sometimes, you know, the amount of time that you think you're going to save by not removing something, the amount of time it's going to take you to try to work around and get to certain bolts and stuff is not going to be worth it. This is not difficult to get out here. You got two wires. So that one just goes on the bottom and actually frees this up a little bit better for us. This here, what we have to do, start pulling on these clips, and we just kind of get it started one at a time, lifting up, and if they go all the way around, and you just want to be cautious, use a screwdriver or whatever, and be cautious and don't break your clips there, but you kind of have to get it all started at once. And once you get it going, it'll okay. So I'm gonna have to get a little screwdriver back here. Oh, I'm forgetting one thing. I've got to loosen these here up, these 10 millimeters. That's where I'm messing up, before I can unsnap it. Okay, so we have to completely loosen these off, or we can't lift it up and out of here. So don't get this real tight when putting it back and mess up your threads. Okay, so let's try this again. Really, I'm making it more difficult than it is, but I said you want to be careful because you don't want to break these clips. I had to replace one of these because there were so many broken. And somehow somebody had managed to break part of the box off, so water and stuff could get in there, and that's no good. Okay, so I've got one more little clip over here that's holding me up, I think. Finally, said it's really not that difficult. I made it way harder than it should have been. So there is that. It comes right up. So just put your lid back on, and these, you know, will seat down in here when you go to put it back, and they will unseat. Now this, I believe, has clips as well. You push out on these tabs, and it should lift up and off of here. It just has tabs going all the way around, and once you get those pulled back, you can lift the whole thing just like that other piece. Almost wish that it had like little screws or something. It's just these clips are real finicky. And I'll just knock something down there. And even once this piece is up and out of the way, you still got another bracket down under there that has 10 millimeters. So we've got one right here, got one nut up here on the firewall, and then we got another one right up there. So we got to take those out, and then we can get this piece out of the way. Okay, let's get on this one down here first. Okay, now we're getting that one studded nut, and then the other one that's right down here. Now there are, these are clipped on here. They'll need to be unclipped and then put those back. We also have to disconnect this, push down really hard, separate that. Same thing with this one over here. Push down there and separate those connectors and just put them back where they go. We get it back together. Okay, so first pop that loose. Same thing with this one down here. And these are really difficult to separate, even after you got them unclipped. They're just such a big connector that you really gotta pull on these with a lot of force. Okay, so there's that one. Just got one more. Now I usually take some of my dielectric grease when I put these back together, and it's just all that dirt and stuff from them sitting there, and they get really tough to disconnect. So now we can work this piece off of these studs, and we'll get that out of there. Okay, let's put that on there to kind of protect that for now. Okay, I want to explain something. This engine is being held up like by like four other mounts that are on the subframes. This here is a torsion mount. By taking this mount loose is not going to make this engine fall or anything, and it may not even move that much, but we'll put it back to where it goes. But basically I need to get to these bolts that are in this bracket for the power steering. I'm not going to be able to do that with all this in the way. Also, we're gonna have to take this coolant hose. I can't get to the bolts on this mount with this coolant hose right here in the way. I don't expect we're gonna lose a lot of coolant because it's so high up, but what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take it loose here. We'll get a pan underneath, and we'll just pull this hose back up here as high as we can so it's not doing any more draining. And I plan on this being tough to get off of here, so we'll go ahead and get started on that and get some pliers, and we'll get a screwdriver to push it off with. We're going to take these two 15s to make it easier to get to this clamp here. I'm going to cheat with my impact. That one. that bolt. It'll look almost exactly the same. Once you wiggle that the right way, it should come right out of there, no problem. Okay, there's a connector here. I believe it goes to like the ABS or something here. I'm going to disconnect that because it's kind of getting in the way. I'm going to take that wire loose right there just to clear up some more slack. Okay, as you can see, I can pull this back up here out of the way a little bit better. Now we're going to, with that, we can get to this clamp a little bit easier here. Okay, I just slipped that back over on this side. Now we're going to get us a bigger screwdriver and start pushing on a little bit of this at a time till we can kind of get that broke loose. And you just have to start working at this little by little. It just is really going to be tough to remove till you kind of get it broke loose there. Okay, there we go. That wasn't too bad. Now I got my pan in place. Hopefully we're not going to have a big old giant mess here. Okay, so we don't need all that leaking out. We're going to pull this hose up where it's high. Okay, I think this is good. I believe I can get to these with a ratchet wrench down here. Let's see this one. This one here is right behind this coolant spout here, but I think we're good at this point. It's questionable. I probably didn't even have to take this over here out, this fuse box and stuff, but I don't know. It makes it easier to get down here to this, because it's been really hard to get to this without having a screw clamp on it. And a matter of fact, I think I'm going to take this one off and put a screw style clamp, because it seems like the last time I had leaks there once I broke that loose. Okay, so just down here working on these, I was using my little ratchet wrench and these are coming out without any difficulty here. So I'm just going to finish removing them. We'll get this bracket out of the way. Okay, so there's barely room to get those little tins out of there, but it does come out. And now, I'm gonna see if we can't get this bracket out of the way. Well, we may have to, in fact, drain our power steering as well, because this runs through this. It's kind of going to be right in the way of trying to do this valve cover. If I don't figure out, probably just going to have to take it loose. I'm just going to start by popping it loose here and hopefully drain the majority of this fluid out. Now if you got a syringe or something, you can also go that route. Okay, sometimes things aren't worth fighting with, and I thought the coolant hoses were bad. These are ridiculous. These are like glued on here. No way, no how is this coming off. I even tried to get it off the reservoir, so I'm going to cut it and just put a new piece of hose in here and not deal with it. Of course, we'll have to get us some more fluid in here, but this stuff is really black and really dark brown and nasty, so it's not going to hurt it any. The main thing, we just want to try to catch it all so it's not ending up on our belt down there. Now, when you're cutting this, you want to cut it almost in two, but you don't really want to go to cutting into the metal or anything below. You're just going to cause a leak. And then we'll just dig the rest off with the screwdriver. Well, if anybody ever has to remove this, they'll appreciate what I've done here.
See, even with this cut, it still just glued itself. So we got the most of that fluid out there. I'm just going to kind of disconnect this end here, and we'll get this tank out of the way. Okay, now this end here actually comes off of here quite easy. Got a little bit of fluid in it here. But that end comes off super easy. Okay, so finally we can remove this bracket. Remember when I was putting one of these engines in, I didn't like that design. It seems like I had everything hooked up and like left that bracket off or something. It was like a really big ordeal. Okay, so we've got, looks like a clip under here, I can see now. And it's attached to the wire. We need to disconnect these connectors. We're just going to squeeze, and need my pick tool because these little clips ain't working. Okay, I really wind up using this all the time anymore, seems like. But see, it comes off there, no problem. Broke so many clips that I just get tired of breaking them. But usually, I don't have that much difficulty. Okay, that one's still not wanting to come loose. Try this one over here. Okay, so all I'm doing is picking up on this part right here. I'm coming underneath and essentially picking up on it because these just get weak or whatever. Same thing here. I'm coming from underneath and picking up on that while I'm pushing down, because it kind of helps to get that latch down and get the pressure off of it. So just got one more here. And said, you got to be careful with these. Sometimes you can't help but to break them because they're just brittle and they're going to break, but you want to try not to, because then it's just one more thing to worry about. And these are, you see how hard they are to get to. Sure wouldn't want one coming loose. So there we have those. This is disconnected, so we can pull this over here. We'll just go ahead and get my air hose. We're gonna blow as much of the loose stuff off of this valve cover, and we shouldn't have any difficulty to speak of. Okay, so this is loose. This, we popped the clips underneath, got that loose. Did take that temperature sensor or whatever right there loose as well. It was right under there just to kind of clear up some slack. So now I'm going to do is go around the perimeter and get all these tins, and we're going to see if we can pop it up and off here. Okay, once you got all your bolts, make sure they're absolutely loose. You're going to need to go around this thing with a putty knife. And throw mine somewhere. There we go. Okay, so you need to go around the edges. You can start up here is where I started. Kind of work the corner in, come around, work this kind of in between where the bolts are, and you'll get enough of it loose where you can just go ahead and kind of break that seal loose and work it up and out of here. Now this is what talking about on the first engine replacement. This is what these engines do, and this is a really bad one here. The replacement engine that I got
I had replaced the valve cover, I think, when I had it out, and I had to swap them or something, but it didn't look anything like this. See, this looks really, really bad. You know, maybe somebody could chime in with what, you know, you could actually use to come in and clean this out with, but this is really bad. So if you don't keep, you know, oil changes, you know, this sort of thing happens, and it's really particularly bad with these engines, and you need to, you know, maybe we can scrape some of this out, clean it up, but I don't know, it's really, really bad. But if it's like this up here, it's also like that down below with a crank and everything, and that's where it's usually you run into the problem, and the oil just can't circulate good, and next thing you know, the engine's locking up. I had one do it. Okay, so anyways, we're going to get back here, and so you pull up on these tabs on this connector, but we've got to get the plugs just like we did on the front one. We're going to get those plugs loose, and then we're going to pop the tabs on this piece so we can lift that plastic piece up, and everything should be loose from this valve cover, and we'll just do the same thing. Take our putty knife and work it loose. Okay, so here I am bringing the rear one out. Same thing, just running the putty knife around pretty much the front, and it came out without too much trouble. And as you can see, the back doesn't look any better than the front here. So we're going to, you know, try to clean it up a little bit, scrape it out, whatever, about the best I can do with it, and clean up the valve covers. But when you see this, it's really, if you don't get this cleaned up, get some product to get this out of here, it's just a matter of time, basically. You know, it's not a matter of if, it's a matter of time before this engine's going to seize up. You know, if it looks like this up top, it's going to look worse down on the bottom. I'm sure that the front breather was clogged up as well. As you can see, this is a part of the problem right here, is this is completely clogged up. There's nothing coming through there. You know, I don't know, maybe it needs a bigger vacuum hose or something on it. Okay, so I'm going to start with this rear one. Start digging this old These things can really be a pain sometimes to get out of here too. So we'll get this, get all this off of here, and we'll get it cleaned up. Some degreaser. I can clean these up really good, but I have a hard time with the cylinder head. No telling if these have ever been replaced. And this is your little grommets here. You get a screwdriver. Okay, so these stick in there pretty good too. Now this was originally the cause of concern. All right, so we've got those out. Let's get it cleaned up, and we'll get our new valve cover gaskets in place. Okay, I've been cleaning on this for a good bit, and we got the surface in here cleaned up, wiped it out a little bit best you could without taking them all and off and dipping them in some cleaner. Okay, guess we're going to do the front one first. So these only will go one way, and on the side they go on. And we also got to get some RTV. I've already cleaned the surface of the cylinder head with some brake cleaner. The other areas, not as critical, but down here where these where the front cover is going to join the cylinder head is going to have to be pretty clean, because that's where we're going to be putting the RTV. So we just want to make sure that's pushed in there good, so it's not going to be falling out on us. Okay, so now we're just going to pop these in, and they should push in fairly easy. Well, I'll take that back. They're not going to. Okay, so I'm going to put a little bit of oil or something on here. Okay, this dielectric grease works pretty good too. So I'm going to just put a little bit of this on here, but it's a lot tighter than I expected it to be. Okay, we'll move on to plan B. All right, that feels nice and flush. Okay, really odd. The first one was really tough to get in place, and then this one just pushed right in. Let me see what this one here is going to do. This one here appears to be going pretty easy too, so I don't know what was up with that first one. Got to point out, this thing does like to try to fall off, so if you can't keep it in place, use this to hold that. Just put a little dab and push it down in that as well. But you definitely want to keep an eye on it, because if it comes out of place, it'll be all messed up. You'll be starting over again. So, anyways, we're going to take a little of this and put up here on the cylinder head. Okay, we're getting ready to set this valve cover. You can notice we put a dab right down at that junction, put a dab right up here. So we're just going to kind of work it back under these wires here. And I'm just going to keep a close eye on my gasket so I don't want it falling off. And I'm going to try to get it under these wires here. While I'm doing that, not to disturb my RTV. This one up here is actually a lot easier to get in place than the rear. Alright, so these should slip over our tubes here. Now, I would have thought these would have slipped on easily. I even put a little bit of grease, but I'm having to work these on and kind of press it out as I'm pushing down on here. All right, what I found worked was a number 27 socket I put kind of over the end of it while I was pushing down. Seemed to pop it down on there nicely. So we're going to go ahead and snug these down about 85 inch pounds. All right, so we're just going to start in the middle. So we've got this set to 85 inch pounds. Now you're going to spend more time on cleanup than anything. I spent a good couple hours on these valve cover gaskets and then cleaning around the cylinder head there. So plan on having to take some time to do a lot of cleanup. So this is, we're just going to go around and torque all these. We'll get on that back when I'm still actually cleaning on the rear one. Now these things, don't try to pop this insulation off or they're going to break just like that. Cut those little tabs or something. But it kind of makes it difficult to clean it with the degreaser with that insulation mess on there. Alright, so I'm just going to go around and double check all these now. Okay, we finally got this rear one cleaned up a little bit. And I mean, you could clean on these things forever. They're so filthy. Now, I did put a little dab of RTV around the gasket as well. I'm a little bit more worried about this one trying to come out of place as I'm fighting it back in here. So, yeah, work it back on these wires here. Okay, even though I put the RTV after I got it back in there into place, I kind of verified my flashlight. I'm just a little bit leery because I've had one of these get out of whack before, and it's not fun having to redo it. All right, so I gotta work these back over this again. I will say that the socket seems to work the best on getting those to go down. They won't just pull down either. But you just get a socket that'll go in there. But I mean, it's enough work without having a fight with those things. I really don't like that design. Anyways, we're going to go around and snug all these up, torque them to 85 foot-pounds, and just maybe we can get some more of the stuff put back together before it gets dark. Okay, we went around and we got all those torqued. We're just going to go ahead and start putting the coil packs and stuff back in back here. And these are all pretty easy to get to as far as torquing them down and just kind of moving the wires where I need them there. We're going to go ahead and get our coil packs, I think, next. Okay, I was reconnecting that O2 sensor I had disconnected. Now these clips merely just clamp in here. I do need to put that piece of insulation back on here because I actually didn't break both of these. Okay, so there we have that. Now we can fasten these back into place here where they go. Just kind of have to feel for those things a little bit. You can't really see them from up here. Easy from here, just a matter of getting everything back together. We'll snug those down next.
Okay, now we got our plugs over here as well that we need to get back in place. Still really, even with all this stuff out, it's still really difficult to see back over in here. Okay, so there's those reconnected. Okay, I think I'm gonna work on this lower intake gasket here next. Go ahead and get our new one. Okay, there's our new one in place, little notch up that way. Go ahead and set our lower intake on. Okay, so we got the bottom of this cleaned up. And I'm sure gas is gonna pour out again. It's been pouring out of this thing ever since I took it loose. All right, so we'll get our bolts, stuff us some rags back in here. Don't need any mishaps. Okay, and here's our two bolts, just one in each corner. Just make sure that they're lined up. Just threading it by hand first. I'll get my 13 millimeter ratchet over here. I'm gonna torque these down, I think about 15 foot-pounds. Right, so we got this set to 15. All right, we're going to go ahead and get our upper intake on. I don't want to take no chances of any rain, and I don't think it's going to get in my way. I've got a couple of vacuum tubes in the back there to get to, but I don't think it's going to be a problem. There's a little locating peg there and up here in the front, so we're going to go ahead and we'll wipe this off a little bit better. Okay, so we've wiped those off a little bit better. And this is that tube that goes back here. I'm gonna go ahead and snap that on, so I don't wanna fight with it. Just kinda push it out of the way. Okay, and I hope I'm not getting too far ahead of myself with this power steering bracket over here. All right, so it should go back on its little alignment pegs. We got our big long bolts. Have to tilt this thing to get the back ones in first. I kind of forgot about that. These were the bolts that made it difficult getting it out. And I guess it's going to be the same going back in. I think I might actually have it there. Nope. Okay, I gotta see what the heck's going on here. Okay, I actually had it there. I just didn't think that I had it. So I'm gonna go 15 on these as well, just kind of judging by the bolt size. Really haven't looked up the torque on this. A little bit harder to get to the back ones here, but it's not too bad. Alright. Now we just got our little bolts that go here. One in the back corner over here. Okay, this thing's wanting to try my patience. Because these back bolts are so long and this is in the way, what happened was that the bolts caught on the gasket going back, and you can see it crinkled it up. Hopefully it's still going to be okay, but I had to take it all back up and look at it. So yeah, this clearance here is really making things difficult. So I got back there and I seen that this wasn't lining up, and lo and behold, it had pushed this whole gasket off of here. I'm thinking it'll be okay once I get it torqued down. Okay, here we go again. I've got some clamps. I'm gonna attempt. They're hitting right there. Okay, so when I was putting this down, what I had to do is take those back long bolts. I kind of like angled them and reached around from back here and angled them into the gasket while holding and watching the gasket, and got them going to where they needed to go, and just kind of slowly got them fed down in there until the back there's room. But you got to do it like a certain way. So we're getting ready to go ahead and torque them. Okay, so we'll just start in the middle. And we'll have to change up extensions and stuff to make it work, but we'll get to them. Okay. it'll get on this other side. Okay, so we're just gonna go down in here. And we got our one in the back here. We'll have to use a shorter one to get to that. Okay, I've just been getting the ones on the corners here as well. Right, it's about to get too late to do anything. We're gonna reconnect a few things here. Go ahead and get our fuel line. And don't forget your little lock. I'll have to hunt that down because I don't know where it's at the moment. Okay, this goes up here. There was no clamp on this. We got to get our little purge valve back on here and reattach that, and then that line. And I need to find that little lanyard. And this is going to go back to our throttle body there. Okay, so we got that rerouted back around here and pushed back on that bracket. And now it's just as easy popping this connector back in. Give that a firm. Right, so we got the fuel line, the purge line, we got the throttle hooked back up, and then we got this line ran back up here. And of course, this one we had hooked to the back of the valve cover. So that takes care of everything there. I think I'm going to go ahead and pop these pull packs back in. And we'll call it a night. And snug those up. All right, so we got those fastened down. We just got to get our cool packs back up here. And this will just set up here on these clips. I really don't have a whole lot left at this point. Okay, this little connector, I need to get back down here. Try to get some slack earlier by taking that loose. Didn't really help a whole lot. Okay. And then we've got our O2 sensor. Alright. Okay, so we'll just get back on the rest of these wires in the daylight and get our coolant and everything over here hooked up. Okay, I went ahead and slipped these insulated pieces back on. I had to pop that hose back off. And I was just making these connections right here and just slipping this piece right back down. We're going to go ahead and get this bracket for our power steering here on next. Okay, so we're just setting this bracket, and this is probably the most difficult part, just getting these little bolts back in. with this mount here. Said you could completely remove this mount, though, if need be. But I'm gonna go ahead and just work these in here. Okay, so I'm just working these in with a little wrench here. Said you probably could save some time taking the mount off, but then you got to take the mount off, and that's gonna cost a little bit more time. This isn't too bad. They're just in a really hard to get at place here. Luckily, they go in real easy. Before we get those tight, we're gonna put this one up here in as well. If we snug those up, we may have trouble aligning this one. This one right under this wire here just goes into the upper intake. Okay, and then this will clip back in its spot here. This one clips down here. So I think next thing, we may go ahead and get this hose back on here. I'm gonna remove that clamp. Now, you can get yourself a set of these at Harbor Freight. I think they're like $10, stainless steel. I'm gonna put just a light dab of this silicone grease on here. I just get tired of these things sticking so bad. But it will, and I still got some coolant in this hose. Okay. Open that up a little more. Okay, and it's not that I don't like the spring clamp. So this thing's got 220,000 miles on it, and these spring clamps like to leak once they get disturbed. Once these hoses got a lot of miles on them, but with these screws styled, you don't have any worries with the leaks. Okay, so we're gonna. So we've got all of our connectors here. We got the hose on. We've got one of my connectors that slipped down right here for the ABS. And I think the next thing, we're gonna go ahead and set our reservoir. I gotta get a little piece of hose to go right here. And just to show you, this end here is still glued on, like cannot move it. So I'm gonna have to cut that end off too. I mean, this just really, this little piece of hose has really glued itself on. Okay, so I'm gonna have to go pick up some hose for that. While I'm waiting on that, I'm gonna see if I can work this piece back in. I don't know what the magic trick is to this. I just fiddle around with it until it goes into place, basically. Okay, we got a little medium Loctite on here. I don't believe this engine moved a bit. I'm threading the bolts right back into place where they were. I'm going to torque these to 35 foot-pounds. I'm just remaking these connections down here that I had took out before. I'm gonna work on slipping this back underneath here. Try to get it back in place.
Right, so I'm just gonna get these little nuts on here, and then we got the one little bolt that goes back down there. Alright, so I'm gonna go ahead and snug these up. Okay, so I'm getting ready to set this back down here. I got some 3/4 hose here, and we're gonna just figure out how much we need here. So we'll cut it about right there. Let's slip that on. So yeah, right there should be plenty. Okay, so we got us some little screw style clamps. Right, I think that's gonna work. I'm just using an 8mm on these. I did forget to put some silicone grease on here, so these will probably stick too. Okay, and you can buy this stuff. It's like $2 and something for a foot of it. A magnet works really good getting these hard to reach bolts and nuts into place. Right, I think we're gonna go ahead and I do have to re-snap that clip or that clamp right there, but we're going to go ahead and get this refilled before we forget. So at least we'll have a little bit of clean fluid. We'll have to work this air out as we, you know, once we get it running here, but we want to go ahead and get this filled. You don't want to mess around and forget, and good way to burn a pump up. Okay, now we're going to get this lower piece here, it just snaps onto this bracket. Get it under these wires here. And it should, you just line it up with them tabs. And it should go right into place. That's locked down. Right, so we're gonna unwrap these and seat them. Okay, so I had to route that wire that was clipped back around there. These just set down in here. Make sure we've got these pulled up. This one just clips right back over there. So now we can go ahead, get our box. And it should just snap right into place. And all we got to do is just get our 10mm and refasten those. And this, if I don't have something going the wrong way, these should go right back into place without any problem. All right, so we're going to tighten these three down. Like I was saying earlier, don't over tighten these. These strip real easy. Just get them down where they're snug and just stop. It's just holding the connector. But very, very easy to strip. Okay, we got our 13 here. So you really can't do a lot to these Acadias without removing this fuse block here. That clears up so much room. All right. Okay, so I was just reattaching this hose and setting our overflow and then putting the bolt 10 millimeter back into our AC line there. Okay, we're just gonna make this connection right here. And we got one of these straps. I'm going to see if I can't get this up here and reattach it if it's long enough. So this could stand to be a little bit longer. Okay. Okay, it was barely long enough, but it's better than it was. Okay, we're just gonna get this back in place now. Okay, we'll just slip that back in there. We'll just go ahead and tighten these. Okay, just kind of doing a check over. Had to redo that connection right there. Lock that, but I'm just kind of doing a check over, and we're getting ready to go ahead and connect our battery up. Everything looks good. We'll leave this cover off until I make sure this is at the proper level once we get the air out. Okay, we got that reconnected. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and get this fill back. Now this is concentrated, so you gotta mix this half and half. Okay, so we got the coolant topped off, refilled the reservoir, power steering's filled. We're gonna go ahead and crank it up, work the air out of the coolant and work the air out of our power steering here a little bit. Okay, now I forgot to mention, you gotta prime the key a couple times because I did take the fuel line loose. I've been checking it over, don't see any leaks anywhere, anything that we took loose. So probably gonna go ahead and just drive it at this point and come back and check the fluids and stuff and make sure the power steering was doing good, but so far everything looks fine. I'm not seeing any issues, and this should definitely take care of any of those leaks that we had on the valve covers. Okay, we're gonna pop this piece back in place. I've verified after it cooled off that the coolant was good. We got the air out. Okay, I'm just taking the oil cap, getting ready to pop this cover back on here. Back in place. Okay, so that's going to do it on this 2008 GMC Acadia. I've took it down the road a couple times. Everything's doing good. There's no leaks, so that's good. So you're looking at $100 for the gaskets, intakes, and your valve cover gaskets. Really not too bad of a job. I think I've spent right at about 9 hours on it. I spent about eight the prior day. I've been out here like an hour finishing up. It really wasn't that difficult. The most time consuming part was cleaning the valve cover gaskets and stuff. That's what I spent time. So if yours are not in this condition, which I've seen them where they're not like this, you know, you won't have to do near as much work to yours. But I had to get a lot of that stuff out of there so I could put them back clean. So that was probably at least 2 hours, if not more, just doing that. So anyways, that's going to do it for the video. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to leave a comment, please do so. As always, I invite you to subscribe, and I thank you for watching.